There is data on less than 1% of the deep ocean. But even within the small amount we have explored, there is life we never expected.
One of the fun things about being a scientist is we learn more about something, and I feel like it just opens up more questions as well.
There are many remotely operated vehicles that dive in the deep ocean. What's special about the Okeanos Explorer is its ability to live stream their dives, allowing anyone in the world to participate in discovering the deep.
Hi, Okeanos, I'm back again.
Hi, Mike. We found something you might really like.
That's a warty octopus, Granuledni varicosa. This is the same genus that out on the west coast.
Is that the siphon? Whoa, that was so cool.
The vast majority of the planet is in deep waters and has never been explored before. So this ship is very special in that it's fully dedicated to going to places that have not been mapped, that have not been surveyed, and collecting baseline information about these places.
The kind of magic around the Okeanos work is their communications capability and the fact that communications is built into what they do. Those kinds of cruises happen regularly in Canada, but we haven't told the world about it.
See, Vinny, this is why I trust you. Look at all the shrimp. Look at this star. Look at this basket star.
And you've got it all on this one.
I got it all.
20 years ago, when we were discovering deep sea corals here, it was a big thing. Nobody's gonna read that 20-year-old media. So I think it's really important that science gets communicated well.
Broadcasting high-definition video has allowed for an unprecedented expansion of understanding in the deep ocean. However, closer to home, research between the USA and Canada has been more difficult to communicate.
What has happened is research has focused on, you know, either side of the border. Organisms do not recognize borders. It's one body of water, and somehow it's, you know, studied separately. And the same with the canyons on the continental slope. They're connected. We decided to put together a research program that crosses borders.
If you're just joining us, welcome to the Deep Connections Expedition of 2019, exploring Atlantic canyons and seamounts of the United States and Canada.
As you work your way down from north to south along the continental shelf, skipping from canyon to canyon, you might see a lot of species in common, and then you'll see a slow gradation of a change in the community as you move further south. So we call that connectivity. And we're really looking for connectivity between the gully and then also in the marine protected areas in the United States.
The Deep Connections mission that explores the Atlantic canyons and seamounts of the United States and Canada started in Halifax, Nova Scotia, and ended in North Kingstown, Rhode Island. Crossing the border between Canada and the USA in the Gulf of Maine, the mission made 12 dives along the continental shelf, exploring depths between 500 and 3,000 meters. The Okeanos Explorer was supported by a command center based out of Halifax. Canadian scientists from the Department of Fisheries and Oceans had a direct connection to the ship and were able to provide insights to the Okeanos as they explored together.
I'd say the Fundian Channel is really interesting because we always see the tides coming in and out of the beaches. Fundian Channel is where all that water goes out off the shelf. And so Nova Scotia has quite an extended continental shelf, which is why we have, you know, very lucrative fisheries. But then that shelf falls off into the deep sea, and it's that really interesting habitat that have all kinds of interesting current activity. If we could see the bottom of the sea, I think we would feel that our province has much higher mountains and cliffs than we have on land. I think we hold Sable Island very dear to our hearts, and the gully is a similar kind of undersea natural wonder. We think of the Sable Island Gully as, you know, it's really an undersea Grand Canyon for Nova Scotia, which is amazing.
Channels and canyons can support a particular type of organism, deepwater corals. The reason they can do this is because the water flows through them very fast. That current brings with it a lot of food, a lot of particles. And that's why you get filter feeders, animals that filter particles out of the water to leave in those places.
Corals are actually ecosystem engineers. They create habitat in the deep sea. So without corals, our biodiversity goes way down. It's just like on land, where you take out a forest and a lot of the animals that you're interested in no longer have homes. So it's important to protect these ecosystems because they provide habitat to so many things and a lot of things that we don't even know about yet.
One of the interesting things in Canada is that our fisheries are actually publicly owned. So the ocean is the one place. It's all under federal government jurisdiction, and the Department of Fisheries and Oceans manages our fisheries for the good of the Canadian public. I think we also have an obligation, not just to Canadians, but also to other countries in terms of protection of biodiversity. Humans aren't doing the best in terms of protecting biodiversity, but we know we need to do better. No one likes to see species go extinct, and we've taken from the ocean for a long time. And I always say we take fish out and we put back pollution. Take out oil and we put back plastic. We take from the ocean. And I think protecting spaces is part of that giving back.
Society has to make decisions. We're at a turning point. We have to pressure politicians. People need to think about how we want this world to be shaped. And so in order to make that decision, the public needs to understand the science that is required. What will be lost if they lose it?
The Natural History Museum in Halifax has an exhibit dedicated to the Gully Marine Protected Area, where kids can explore the mysteries of the deep. As a special event for the Deep Connections mission, the museum went a step further to live stream the dive within the Gully Marine Protected Area.
I think as you develop excitement and develop wonder about something, to be able to see it as it's being discovered, that's kind of a cool way to enter the whole experience, pulls us into that little bit of excitement of like, what's gonna be there, what we're gonna see as we're going down.
I did like the jellyfish. I think I like the color. Kind of pinkish reddish. Yep.
I hope getting to see these deep sea animals and getting to explore with us, with the Okeanos Explorer, inspires future generations into ocean exploration and research and want to learn more about our oceans.
We can explore deeper down so that we know more about the world and how to help it.